Number 14 on the financial accounting exam prep deals with treasury stock. You'll recall that we issued common stock previously out to different people, and they're now our investors. They own that common stock. But we have the ability to buy some of that back. We call that a treasury stock because we're actually buying it at the market price that's out there. Remember how it was a dollar par value? Well, that doesn't mean anything anymore other than we record common stock at that. That additional paid in capital was all the extra money that those people paid us for the stock initially. That doesn't matter for what we're doing either. We're essentially going out to the market and just buying $5,000 of our own shares. Well, the market's got it at $20 a share. So we're going to have to shell out $100,000 to buy that back. Why do we buy treasury stock back? Well, we might be under the process of giving it to some of our employees as incentives or some of our executives, so we'll keep that stock. Plus, it allows us to basically invest in ourselves. As the stock goes up, it increases the equity because it is an equity item in owning our own stock. So the treasury stock, we see that cash going out the door for $100,000, and we've bought it back. And we put it in an equity account called treasury stock. Treasury stock acts as a contra equity account. Contra equity. Equity accounts are normally increased with credits. It's contra, so it's increased with a debit. So think of it. We put all that stock out there. That's the value, but we bought some back. That's the treasury stock. So it reduces the amount that's out there outstanding in common shares to other investors besides us. So that's the answer for question number 14.